Hi everybody. So we are going to start a new color along, and I was asking if I could do another Kanoko Egusa page, and of course I said yes. And this page is a freebie that you actually can get, so everybody can join in. You don't have to buy a book or buy anything. I will link where you can get this page underneath this video here. If you press that little arrow saying "Show more," you then you will find a link to where I got this little page from. So Christmas. So of course we have. I wanted to do the Christmas tree, or actually that was Sarah as well, but I think it's a super cute page. So I said yes, let's do it. But this time we won't be working with the ink test, but with our Allbäcker. Now I have had this for some years, and I'm so sad because I never get to use them as much as they serve. So it's time to pull them out. And I know that there are several others like me out there who have them but never use them or don't use them enough. So but you don't have to have the Allbäcker from Faber-Castell. Any watercolor pencils will work. So whatever you have that is water, or what type of watercolor pencil that you have. You can pull them out and join us. And you can of course also do this with the ink tents. So and what I'm thinking of doing is like separating this into small parts again, trying to make shorter videos, and also so that it's easier for people to follow the only those part that they would like to follow. So if you don't want to see or follow everything, but for example just only see how I did that mice, then you can just go to that video and watch that, and you don't have to sit for hours and watch. So I want to start with the background because things are going over the back around here. So the back wall, the brick wall, is what I wanted to focus on today. So let me see if I can zoom you guys in a little bit, like that maybe. Pull that little mice or that little page down. So I have cold gray, which is 255. Cold gray, I mean, this is number 6, and I have a cold gray, this is two, number 251, I believe. Yeah, and I'm using cold gray because I'm going to have in this cement part there, and that has never been alive. It is a dead cold thing, so that is why I use the cold gray and not the, for example, the warm or the French gray. For the barracks themselves, I have pulled out from my darkest tone the wall at around 177. I will of course list everything underneath here as well. I have the burnt sienna, which is 283. Is that it? I think so. And we have the terracotta, a beautiful color, one of my favorites, which is 186. And I pulled out this copper, which is 252, a color that I never use. And that is a metallic as well, so that hopefully it will give a little bit of a shine to everything. I'm also working with two kinds of water brushes. So this is the Faber-Castell. I think this is called classic or signature. And then they have this one, this type that looks like a syringe where you just pull up the water. The classic one here has quite a broad tip, so that is big, good for big spaces. Well, this one has a little bit more pointier, so I have those ready next to me as well. And of course I have an old rag which I'm wiping my tips off. I also have out my Caran d'Ache palette that I scribble things out on, and probably, so I'm probably going to use that. I don't know if we will use it today, but I have it here so that it is ready. So I'm taking the cold Gray 6, the darkest one, putting that down the top part there. Maybe we should zoom you guys in even more, maybe like that. Let me see if we can, there. I have just taped my page to a, like a cutting mat, actually. So I'm just taking that darker, or the darkest color in this, where these lines meet. So I'm going to do that all the way on my page. Back there and up here as well. The paper that I printed this image out on is a Vincere Newton watercolor paper, just because I prefer to work on that. And when I finally found a watercolor paper that goes through my printer, I really like to use that with all kind of this water base. Switching on to the cold Gray, and just, I mean that cold Gray 2, where both of them was of course cold Gray. So I'm just coloring those parts there. So this is the cement part. And I really think that this image is so cute for Christmas color along. So when Sarah suggested it, I jumped on it and was like, yes, let's do this. So thank you, Sarah, for the suggestion. I hope that people will enjoy it. So taking up the walnut barrel. Of course you can dilute this Gray if you want to, but I think that I will rather dilute everything at once. I think that so I'm just putting that walnut barrel on the outer edges and stuff, because that is the darkest color that I will have here. So I'm making some lines as well, some cracked lines. Coloring the corners maybe. I'm also trying to make the rocks, or the bricks I mean, a little bit different, so that not every single one of them is the same, because bricks aren't, they are different every one of them. So how is your Christmas preparation going? I hope that you all shop online and stay out of the shopping malls and stuff, and that you do things in a safe way and don't risk getting the virus and stuff. So putting that away, picking out the burnt tea again now. I have gotten at least so far every gift and everything that I needed online, and so that is quite awesome. And I even started shopping from the crafting stores and the shops that sells hobby stuff and watercolors and art things and yeah, everything here really. Norway doesn't have that or isn't that used to online shopping within Norway really. I think that we have been very good with online shopping, but from abroad shops. But this year we actually have started buying more and more online from Norwegian shops as well. That's good. So I have the copper. I don't quite know where to put that, so I'm just, oh my god, that was scratchy. That's pretty hard really. Oh my god. Those other Albrecht Dürer pencils are quite soft and nicely, but this not that much. Come on. And I don't really think that it gives out a lot of color either. So it's really, really pale. Can it be that it's there? Maybe if I try to sharpen it a little bit, maybe. Maybe it's just old. All in there. So let's see now. I don't know if that helped. I don't think so. Actually, no. Well, at least now I know. And this is the terracotta one, which is the base or the main color of this. So I'm just putting that down. I don't put color in the middle. So I'm trying to leave some highlighted areas uncolored. Because this is the, like this same with the ink tents where I will pull color into the highlight or into the uncolored parts. But I will still keep them quite uncolored and white. Right, just to get a nice contrast. So that's it. So I'm taking the Faber Castell waterbearer here, which has this barrel nip. Start to wet this from the uncolored area and working my way around. I'm not trying to dilute all the lines that I put in here, because the lines will help to make it look more real. And oops, OK, Okay, that was not smart. That will. Maybe I should dilute the array first then. And the orange barracks. After that, come from the light area into the dark. Pulling some of that dark with me. That bled a lot. Well, I think it still looks good. So I'm just wetting the gray parts, the cement now. And hopefully that has dried up well enough so that when I wet the barracks, they won't bleed. And Alpex Durer are pencils, like I said, I don't have, haven't used them enough, which is just so sad. There. So let's start diluting the barracks. And that also includes that I am not as familiar with them as I am like my inktense. So mistakes will probably happen, but we are learning as we are going on with this. So just pull it a little bit over. I like the nice specks and lines that we have gotten in here. Trying to not to color over that star. Wiping my tip off. That. Actually, I think I need to even that out a little bit. Yeah, like that. I like this. I think it's looking good. So I'm just going to show you these barracks here. And then I will do rest of them off camera, and then I will come back and do another part together with you. So I'm just showing how I will go on doing this page. Like that. Trying to be careful not to smear that poor mouse in all of my colors. Like that. I do think that this paper maybe helps me get more of the texture out as well. The Winsor Newton. Like the normal paper is actually very good watercolor paper. I really, really like it, and I use it so much. I use my cotton paper when it is something like special I want to paint. But for everyday things and fun and coloring pages, I just use that. Or I use this Winsor & Newton. I think I heard somebody called it classic paper once, but I can't find it anywhere online. It doesn't really say that it is only or cellulose, but the cotton paper says that it contains cotton. So the paper that doesn't say that it contains cotton, that is cellulose paper. So yeah, like that. Ooh, I like this. Though I might go in, or yeah, I guess I have to go in and darken up some of those that cement parts. Those are a little bit too light, so I just darken some of those up. A cement wall is not even at all, so I'm not trying to get that to get it even. I want to look it like it looks some kind of natural. Was very much, or that was too white. So this is the lightest, the cold gray. Was this too? You can just fill around and put in a stock of a cement that you want to. Just don't make everything the same color because then it will look flat. A trick to make things look lively is to use different shades of the same color, like, or yeah, like if you are coloring a blue thing, use different blues. It will give it so much more life. Now this copper really doesn't, or didn't do anything. Trying to see if I can. No, I can't go over it. Won't even do anything there. See if I can. What is the point of having these metallic pencils if they don't work and don't give you that metallic, that shine? So it kind of gives you brownish. Can't really see, or maybe I can actually when I tilt my head a little bit, then I actually can see a little bit of the metallic. At least now when it's wet. So I'm just putting some of that down there, so that it. So hopefully that it sparkles just a little bit. No, it's not even visible for the camera, but and it's not really much at all. Maybe it's just what I see is actually the wet from the water, I guess, not the pencil itself. Anyways, well, now we know. So I'm going to keep on working this brick wall, and then I will be back in the next episode. Then we will color something else. I think that we should actually then do the tree itself, the pine tree itself. Thank you everybody for watching, and if you want to join in and you color this with me, please tag me so that I can see it. I'm mostly on Insta. I don't not that much on Facebook anymore. I'm just checking in there like once a week or something. But I am on Insta every day I pop by. So please tag me and let me know. Let me see what you are doing. So, so to darken, or I want to darken up that part there. Yeah. Anyways, thank you everybody so much for watching, and I hope that you all stay safe and take care, and I will see you all later. Bye.